I'll tell you, Sammy, a religious singing reminded me of something. Did you see that TV coverage of the Pope when he was lying in state? The last Pope, you know, John Paul.
Yeah.
Lying in state on that on that catafalque.
Yeah.
In those robes.
All right.
Didn't half give me the horn that. Him lying there. He looked so fucking vulnerable, didn't he? I mean, like, I couldn't prevent myself, you know, having a wank immediately because he looked vulnerable. He looked at rest, and somebody had gone to the trouble of plucking all that hair out of his nostrils. I didn't fancy him when he was alive because he had all this fucking hair up his nostrils. But when they'd when the cosmetician had had a go at his body and that,
well, I got a
I got the fucking horn. Yeah, just seeing him. Lying well, there.
The makeup was fantastic on that.
I imagine.
Who done the wardrobe?
What, for the Pope's funeral?
Yeah.
Was it Verity Lambert, was it?
Was it Mr. Fish?
Mr. Fish or.
Yeah, I don't know.
Or could be Mrs. Fish done it, I don't
know.
Yeah,
I don't know.
Because she does a lot
it's
of things.
Bloody beautiful. But it's interesting, gave you the horn.
Well, I find I'm, you know, I'm attracted by dead popes.
By dead popes, yeah.
And, you know.
I can understand that. I can understand that. It's enough to give you the horn. Anything gives me the horn, I find. I can look at anything. I look at a picture of a piece of toilet paper. I get the horn.
You get
I get a very hard horn. Not just the horn.
Just Bronco or just Andrix? What?
Well, no, I don't distinguish. I don't distinguish anything.
Anything gives you the horn.
Anything gives me the horn. I'm very lucky that way. Except my wife, Valerie. She doesn't give me the horn at all.
No, she's an ugly
bitch. I've explained to her time after time. I said, Val, I said, fuck knows what it is, love, but you do not give me the horn. I said, you fucking don't give me the horn.
I'll tell you what.
But everything else gives me the horn. I went down, I opened the gate, that gave me the horn. I, you know, put my foot on the pavement, that gave me the horn.
Yeah.
You know, everything gives me the horn.
Yeah.
I like that.
Lord Longford gives me the fucking horn.
Oh, yeah.
Well, it's the way he does his hair.
Yeah.
You know, it really gets me going.
Yeah,
I see him wandering about.
Yeah.
He's so fucking fanciful, that Longford.
Fucking hell, mate.
I wish I was in prison for
drives
life.
Drives me round the bend.
I wish I'd killed a few people. I wish I was in prison.
So
I wish
round.
I was a mass murderer and I was in prison so Lord Longford could come round and give me the horn like he gives other people, you know. Because I only see him in photos and on telly and that.
Yeah.
But in the flesh, I imagine he must be fucking tasty.
You strip
me. I mean, think of that lucky girl, Mara Hendley,
down to his
sitting there.
Mate.
He's coming round on daily visits to see her.
Mm. I bet he gets. I wonder if he gets the horn.
I'll tell you another thing gives me the horn.
What's that?
The word "and."
Oh,
whenever I see the word "and,"
you've picked a favourite of mine.
I'd get so fucking
horny. Oh, fucking "and," mate. Oh, Jesus! And there's such a lot of it about.
Yeah. This and
fucking
that.
Fucking and
know.
This and that and
this
that.
This gives me the horn, that this gives me the horn.
And that gets. Oh, fucking
if
shit.
If I see a sentence which reads this and that, I'll get such a fucking hard one. I don't know what to fucking
mate.
Do.
I wrote to the editor.
The is another one gives me the horn.
Oh, the. Oh, come.
They keep using that one, don't
have you
they?
Have you been reading my diary? Have you?
Yeah, I was looking through it, you know.
Well, fuck me. I don't think that's very nice.
No, it wasn't. What I read was.
You saw my secrets.
Yeah, I saw that.
You
one
knew
about.
That I liked the and end.
Yeah, I knew that. That's why I mentioned the and
well,
to see if it would give you the horn. Of course it has.
Of course it has. Oh,
but you wrote to the... Who did you write to about this?
Well, I sent a round robin.
Yeah, that's no fucking good one. You send a letter.
Well, I sent the letter later.
What, with the robin?
No, I sent robin and then, that, you know, it didn't do fuck all, so I sent a letter.
Robin Peter to pay Paul, that is. It's just fucking stupid. Why didn't you write a letter?
I did
send him some round fucking robin.
I sent Robin round because I thought that would be the way to do it.
What, Robin had the letter?
No, I just sent Robin round.
What good is Robin going round? Where the fuck did Robin go round to?
He didn't go round nowhere, I just sent him round.
Round where?
He came back, he said, where the fuck am I supposed to go? I said, I don't fucking know, I sent you round, why don't you fucking go round?
Why didn't you send a letter?
Cunt.
What, have you sent a letter?
I did send a letter, yes.
Who to?
I don't know. I don't know. I sent the fucking letter. I wrote the letter and put it in the pillar box. I don't know who I sent it to.
Well, you didn't put a stamp on or address or anything like that.
Fuck that.
Well, why don't you follow what John Cleese says on television?
I do.
He says, in order for post to get there, he comes out with all these handy fucking hints. He says, put a stamp on a letter and address it. That's what I've been doing since I've seen those ads.
Write the letter and bung it in a fucking post box.
What, with no address?
No address.
Well, did you get a reply?
No. I was fucking furious. I wrote another letter.
What, same method?
Yeah, got no fucking reply again. Cunts. They're all cunts out there.
I wrote to Mrs. Thatcher.
Yeah, well...
I said, dear Mrs. Thatcher, you know, respectful. Pardon the language, but I've got the fucking horn. And, you know, I thought I'd put it bluntly. Dear Mrs... I didn't call her Maggie. I wasn't familiar. So, dear Mrs. Thatcher, I have got the fucking horn, and I want to know what you, as leader of the Conservative Party, plan to do about it, you know. I was expecting a reasoned reply of some kind.
Yeah.
Well, I got a fucking letter come back saying...
The horn not known at this address?
No.
Oh.
It said, Mrs. Thatcher has read your inquiry with interest, but it will not be part of official Conservative Party policy, though we are sympathetic to your cause. Well, in my view, she hadn't even read the fucking thing.
Right.
I think some fucking secretary looked at it.
Yeah, right.
Wrote to Jim Callan.
Tossed it on one side, if you pardon.
Wrote to Callan. That oily heap of shit. I didn't call him that, you know.
No.
I said, dear sir.
You didn't say, dear oily piece of shit, did you?
No, because that would offend him. He's teetotal and Welsh. And no, he's not Welsh, is he? He's just a cunt of some kind. I forget. He comes from somewhere.
Yeah, well, we all do.
All right.
We come from the horn, mate. All of us.
All right, to Jim Callan. I said, dear Mr. Callan, I have got the fucking horn, and I want to know what the fucking hell the fucking Labour Party are going to do about the fucking horn. I got absolutely no fucking reply. He's probably huddling with a TUC.
What's that?
I did a quite good experiment for BBC Two. They're doing a documentary.
Oh, what, on the horn?
Yeah, on the horn. And the documentary people came around, you know, with the cameras. And at first I was a bit self-conscious, you know, like having cameras on, you know, all fucking time.
Yeah, well, fuck
and they
that,
said,
mate.
Lie down on the bed.
Fuck them.
I said, lie down on the bed.
We're
doing this documentary on masturbation, you see.
Yeah, fucking.
I said, don't call it masturbation. I said, call it wanking.
Call it a horn.
Call it wanking. Yeah. Call it having the horn and wanking, I said. But they insisted on calling it masturbation, you know. BBC Two, they have to use long fucking words.
Yeah, fucking cunt.
And I forget who was the producer, Xavier Cugat or something like that.
Radio 3, BBC Two.
Yeah, all that stuff.
Fucking.
I said, lie on the bed and masturbate.
Mm.
And. I said, what is my motivation? And he said, the. And as soon as he said the, I started, you're pumping away, you know.
Yeah,
and it all come out, you know, a great mass of it. And,
yeah, well, endless gobs.
No, about.
Huge gobs of hot sperm spurting.
Well, let's face
endlessly
it.
Into the air, was it?
Quite a lot, and it all landed in me belly button.
And your hair.
And they said, I was just going to get a Kleenex, you know, wipe it out. And they said, no, hold that, that's good. We like that.
Yeah.
We like that. It's very visual, you see. It said, very visual. They said, could you do that again? Because we've got a hair in the gate. I said, fucking hell, you've got a fucking hair in the gate. You're fucking professionals. They said, it could happen to anyone, you get a hair in the gate.
Yeah.
So I had to do the whole thing again, and he said that again.
What?
And I waited away for half, you know, about half an hour, because I'd only just come. And then they said, I said, is that all right? You know, I came. And they said, no, we can't buy that one. I said, why not? They said, because you fell short of the belly button. Yeah. I said, well, fucking hell, what do you expect a second time around?
Should have got me, mate. I can come every 5 minutes.
Well, I sent them round to your place. I told Xavier Cugat, whoever's in charge of the fucking crew, I said, go round to Derek's place. He'll give you a proper wank and hit his marks. I wrote to the fucking BBC after his experience with her, you know, coming in my navel, then falling short, and then them all pissing off. Load of cunts, BBC.
Fuck,
they
fucking know about
Guinness,
the horn?
They drank all my
What's
Guinness.
What's BBC Two know about the fucking horn?
Nothing.
Fuck all.
I said to them, go around to Derek's place, he'll show you.
He'll show you.
And I wrote a letter to them. I said, I wrote to whatever the fucking name is, the head of the fucking BBC.
Dear cunt.
Yeah, that's what I said.
That's it, yeah.
I'll put cunt London on. You'll have to find
him. Cunt TV
London.
TV centre.
Not even TV centre.
No.
Don't have to put TV centre. Cunt London. It reaches the Director General of the BBC. You can be certain of that.
Yeah.
So I said, fucking dear cunt.
Your
fucking crew came round my fucking place last night and tried to film me fucking masturbating.
Right.
And I did it perfectly well the first take.
Right.
And they said they got a fucking air in the gate.
Yeah.
And I'm paying £25 a fucking year to have a fucking colour.